Bleu? Blanc? Combien d'avant?
Deuxième.
Combien d'avant bleu? Quatre bleus. Mêlée. On va décaler. Gauche, gauche. Distance, le canal est de distance, la bonne distance. Un peu plus. On peut trouver la bonne distance. Ça marche, la bonne distance. Flexion. Yes. Lié. Je.
1, 2, 3, 0.
Le ballon est là. J'attends, je ne suis pas attendu. D'accord, ce côté là, hein. Voyez. Approchez-vous. Mettez-le de suite, hein. Attends, si je vous le demande. Flexion. Lié. Je.
1, 2, 3, 0, oui.
Le ballon est ici, vous tournez, vous enroulez. Au lieu de rentrer dans l'axe, vous enroulez et vous poussez intérieur. Faut absolument que vous trouviez plus près parce que.
Bon.
Ok.
Moi
ça me va. Faut maintenir le standard pour le match. Hein. Merci. Mathieu, c'est de côté.
Number one, and you're going to have a good run. I suppose he probably didn't have that last year, swapping in with Brock James a fair bit, and with Brock James being such a legend at Clermont as well, it was hard for him. But I think I really rate Lopez. I think he's a top running player, has got a nice kicking game as well, and is quite happy to take the ball to the line and attack it as well. So, to him and Power are such a good partnership for Clermont.
Good to La Rochelle, of course, Brock James, you say a real legend. Won yesterday to La Rochelle, 22 points to 19 over Bernard Jackman's Grenoble. That's two losses now for Grenoble. Kadjokalis, the man in the 10 shirt, of course, Francois Tranduc now at Toulon. And this man is preferred to Ben Bottiger today. And of course, started the Challenge Cup final victory over Harlequins, and Ben Bottiger came on as a sub.
Interesting signing with Ben Bottiger, and I think quite similar player to Kadjokalis. Both kind of steady players. Not the greatest of runners, more. You're kicking, which is obviously why the French kind of like him there.
And fit into that Jake White plan, very structured way of playing.
Yeah, so Ben Bosker's probably got a little bit more to his game than Kadjokalis, but you're not surprised that Kadjokalis is starting their first home match, and they may well be that they're rotating him and Bosker for the first few games to find out who will take that number one jersey.
Plante coming. A little angle off Lopez, can take the ball. This Scott Spedding. He could have been still out with the groin injury. He's been named in the elite French squad. Scott Spedding alongside Var Mahina and Schuli. Teammates at Clermont. Bismarck Duplessis, one of a plethora of South Africans in this Montpellier squad. Resisted the temptation, only signed another couple of South Africans in the off-season. Here's Fofana, but they did sign this man, Ndolo. And when he shifts, he really does, like an absolute steam train.
They're all a little disappointed that was advantage, because it was going to be Nakataki against Ndolo down the wing one-on-one. That would have been a great battle to see who's going to come on top. But yeah, another penalty against Montpellier. Came from the lost line-out. Montpellier's set piece not going well. Be disappointed with that first 6 minutes. Scrum penalty, lost line-out. On to another penalty for Lopez. He'd be disappointed if he doesn't knock this one over as well.
I mean, we make no excuses for it. We will say it, and we'll say it a thousand times as this season unfolds. It's a simple game. You've got to get your basics right. That's a penalty at the first scrum against Montpellier. The line-out's not going well. Not going to win the game without the ball. And it's Lopez. With his second opportunity. And it's the second time that the assistant referees, I should say, have had to raise their flags above their heads. And it is 6-0 to the opposing team. And this is the way that Clermont like to do it. They like to go out hard, don't they? Get a really big lead in the game.
Yeah, and it's the complete opposite to what Montpellier would have wanted. Their first home match. Good crowd in. Try and get a good start. Get the crowd behind them. Make it a tough place for Clermont to go, whereas actually they've made it easy for Clermont. Clermont haven't done a huge amount and have got a nice 6-point lead.
I'm going to guess that's part of Jake White's thinking is the South Africans in who don't understand the home and away, the away apathy in French rugby. No, John O'Gibbs has brought a certain element of that to Clermont as well.
Yeah, he came in and tried to change the mentality at Clermont that winning away from home is important, and last year they won 9 matches, which is the most they've ever won away from home in the top 14, and I think it did affect their home form. Lost a couple at home that they wouldn't normally do, but they did end up finishing top by 6 points.
Montpellier, when they get their basics, their set piece right, just how powerful and physical they can be.
Yeah. Good take from the line out, a good drive, got the ball going forward, and then from that they managed to pick and go, and there was an almost an unstoppable force coming through. The pick and go, making yard after yard. Williams is a big bloke to stop from a yard out.
And there's large athletic lumps out there. He's right at the top of that chart. Paul Willemser took the line out, worked hard, didn't he? It was 2 carries, the second carry that came up with a score. But that's better for Montpellier. Slightly edgy start at home.
Yeah, it came from kickoff, and Clermont caught the ball, but Montpellier did really well to tackle. I think it was Nick White into touch and got the line and got the territory. That's the first time they've been in Clermont's half, and won the set piece, and the rest is, as you said, Johnny, is simple rugby.
That's a simpler kick than Dimitri Kechakalis has made it look. Misses off the tee as we watch a rerun of Willemser's try. You want to start any league around the world, any game of rugby at the home side, you want to start well, don't you? You're going to put that doubt in the mind of the opposition that they don't come to your patch and win, but even more so in France. But not what Montpellier have done here. They've given Clermont that 6-point lead, and it's Philips's partner in the second row, Mikwadzi, who takes the restart very athletically.
Blue stop!
Proud of that in Rio, that kind of athleticism. Spedding.
Two quite kicking fullbacks playing today, Scott Spedding and Jesse Mogg. Jesse Mogg with a big left foot, Scott Spedding with even bigger right peg. Easily got 50-60 metres in his boot. Can be used as a long range goal kicker as well. You can easily hit him from 55, especially in that stage. It's not a big pitch, not a lot of wind there, so especially when it's warm. Sure, if there's any penalties on the halfway, they'll be using him instead of Lopez. Expect Montpellier to look to drive this again as they come off the top.
Fly half for you.
Yeah, they should have driven that one.
Yeah, look at the mistakes they've made now. Hindsight is a wonderful tool.
But to be fair, as a fly half, you'd say, right, we'll have it off the top. We've got a really nice backs move we want to create.
And you never get it.
And then two phases later, one of your backs knocks it on and the forward goes, well, why didn't we just drive it anyway and make 30 metres and got a penalty? So it's disappointing. Just expect Benjamin Fall to be a bit better than that. Top player. Big, big physical winger. Not quite as big as Nadolo on the other wing, but as a top carry for them. And he'd be disappointed if his first touch that he knocks on and gives possession away. Just as Montpellier were looking to build something into the game.
Flexion.
Didier Bess, assistant coach at Clermont, looks on. Benjamin Fall has signed a new contract after the 2020. I clearly rate the former Racing winger. Sanga. He's done well, the youngster. He was thrust into the limelight, wasn't he, with their injuries last season to Morgan Parrott and Radoslavjevic. He's preferred today. Still a member of the academy. 21-year-old.
You got Parra on the bench, so if he's not going well, then you'd be surprised if Parra's on quite early in the match. But that wasn't his fault. That was a good steady scrum from Clermont, but poor pass from Lopez, who did him no favours. A nice training ground move, but fortunately, it doesn't matter how well you're on the training ground, you need to do well on the pitch.
There's a bit of rust out there. I mean, we choked during the Toulouse game last night. 57 days between Racing playing in that final and starting this season. Lyon already in pre-season when that final was being played at the new Camp. Extraordinary short turnout. So expect a little bit of rustiness from these two sides as Jesse Mott flicks it on and Dumoulin. Oh, his greatest touch.
Clermont did well to rush up and try and put a bit of pressure on Dumoulin, but he'd expect a man like him to be able to, if it wasn't on, just to hold on to the ball a bit. There was space for Nadolo on the wing, but I think Andrea Plante did well to block the pass off.
Dumoulin, of course, came from Paris in the summer. Played in the Champions Cup final, of course, in that loss to Saracens. Got injured in that game, so wasn't able to put the wrongs of that Champions Cup final in the top 14 final.
Flexion.
Those Racing won. He joins his old mate Benjamin Fall, though, in that back line for Montpellier. They were teammates of the French under-20s side 8 years ago now. Good, steady scrum.
Hard work in the front row, isn't it? Keeping that pressure on.
Shuley. New directives that they grew up their heads will tell you about. The ball's at number 8 feet and the pack isn't going forward. You were going to call from the referee to play the ball quickly, immediately. Mok Ndolo, star of the World Cup, wasn't he, the big Fijian?
Yeah, what a player. Such a big bloke, 128 kilograms, and run as fast as he can, and such a good footballer as well. Can goal kick?
Certainly can goal kick. He's scored 192 points for Fiji, 25 conversions, 19 penalties to go with his 17 tries.
Selfish, really, isn't it? Hogging the ball all the time.
You'd know. It's going to be hard work out there. The weather is warm, but there is a little bit of pressure. We only round two, of course, of a, as we already mentioned, a very long season. But Clermont, repeat of last year in their first round game, were at La Rochelle. They put 41 points in them last season with a 5-try display. This year, 30-point draw after going out and having a really big lead and allowing La Rochelle to come back into it. Montpellier, of course, lost to Toulouse last week, so there is certainly pressure on Montpellier at home to get the job done this afternoon. Let's start a campaign with two losses.
Exactly. Possibly weren't expecting a win against Toulouse away first up, but at home, yeah, they'd be expecting to come away with something today, and so they don't want to be none from two.
Spedding just had to be quick of thought and body then. It was a horrible old pass. No doubt you've taken a few of those in your time behind the try line.
As long as you pick it up and it makes you look good, then you don't mind. It's if you knock it on, then you give the death stare to the scrum half.
Mention no names.
But Clermont are lucky. They've got a few good kickers across their back line. Obviously, Spared, who you mentioned. Benton Stanley put the last clearance kick in. Good left foot on him. And Camille Lopez. So they've got options there. Makes it a lot easier as a fly half if you can move it one pass to a centre or 15 who can use a space. Obviously harder for the defending 15 if he's got to cover different kickers. It's a lot harder rather than just having one kicker and knowing exactly where he's going to go.
Had to make a change, Clermont here. Pacilli Yato has come on for Julian Bardi, the Portuguese international. Here he is, straight into action. It's his fellow countryman, Nkapusi Nguera.
Interesting to see where Clermont go with this scrum. They had a similar scrum 5 minutes ago, and it was a poor pass from Lopez to Sanga. So we'll see, are they going to go a bit more direct, possibly? Maybe look to get from Fofana or Stanley over Katrakilis, who isn't the greatest defenders. Maybe look to tie in him, and then look to go a bit wider after that.
There is Jake White.
They brought Nakatake round as well. There's the three of them in the line. Interesting to see what play they've got coming off the scrum. Hopefully we get to see as the ball comes out.
Surely. Here's Nakatake. Spedding. Fofana. It was a sensible thing. He's just running out of a little bit of space, but Jesse Mok picks it up. Two tries in the semi-final. Montpellier reached in the top 14 last season. Nahola just brushes off Plante, but there was a foot in touch, was there. Well, Plante, he's back on his feet. Did not shy away from the challenge. That's the way to do it.
Definitely go low on Ndolo. I think if Ndolo had a couple of yards more space, then I think Plante might have been in trouble. But so he go low, trying and get where he's at his weakest.
Not entirely sure what the whistles and boos are about. Sometimes have good reason to question the officials, but the assistant referee, as you can see here, was. What's that? 2 metres away from where Naholo put, no doubt, a huge size 14 boot into touch.
That's the home crowd. They're allowed to boo anything like that.
Chimani takes the line and it's Plontek. Stanley was on hand and it's Yato, but he's knocked it on. Then Franz Steen knocks it on as well. A bit frantic there, and a very, very simple training ground move. Managed to find a huge amount of space.
There's a lovely ball from Lopez. It likes to take the ball flat to the line, put Plante through the hole. So it's Cuera who's come too hard onto Lopez and left too much of a gap inside of him. He's tried to get to Lopez and hasn't got his forward inside him to come with him. He's left the big hole and he's a prop inside of him, which is why there's the disjointedness in the line. But it's a two-on-one there. Plante should have given it to Stanley, who was with him, or Fofana. Good tackle from Lodolo, but it was a two-on-one. They did the first part, just didn't finish it off.
Can Courier, this young flanker, beautiful dink for Fofana. Had to choose right man, Stanley. Will it bounce for spending it work? It bounces for Jesse Mott, and he stops. Stay. Is he going out to touch? Bismarck Duplessis. Takes a man of Almahina's size to bring him down. Here's Mitraga. Questions whether he would be the captain. This completely new cultural change at this club. Mitraga, the only man left who, of course, went to the famous Sam Pick-San-Loop school. Alongside the likes of Tranduk and Pickemoult, the only one left at the club now.
Lovely touch from Lopez, nice and flat, the perfect chip for Fofana, but does the right thing, links up with Stanley, but so if he gets that ball away to Spedding, he's probably going to be in. That's two tries that Clermont have given away, but lovely touches from Camille Lopez. The pass on the inside and that chip is just perfect. The awareness that the Montpellier haven't got a sweeper behind the line out. The scrum half was defending in the line out, so there was space there, but the execution to get the chip blanc perfectly, so Fofana didn't have to break stride.
He is a confidence player, isn't he, Kerry Lopez? He seems to be right in the groove this afternoon.
He's so good because he will take the ball flat, even there. He took it right to the line before the chip, which means it's a lot more effective. If he does it 5 metres further back, the defenders can turn and get back and challenge for the ball. Clermont under more pressure though.
Bismarck Duplessis arrived after the World Cup, didn't he, with his doctor brother, Yanni, who's on the bench today. 7 tries Lucas scored last season. Many from this attacking weapon is Nick White, formerly the Brumbies. It's not gone to hand. Where's it going to go? It goes into the hands of Nakatafi. Been chased down by Mark. Oh, and he shrugs him off. And Nakatafi will go the length. Noah Nakatafi, French international. 7 tries last season. Another one here at Montpellier.
I think he barely got out of third gear then as well. Just fobbed up Jesse Mogg with a good handoff. Great pickup as well. Phil Montpellier were on front foot. Good drive. Poor ball from White to Nadolo. Obviously, new players coming together. They're not reading each other's game there. Not reading the lines they're running. That's an amazing one-handed pickup under pressure. And then we talked about going low when Nadolo was running. You've got to do the same with Nakitaki. Powerful runner. You go high and you're susceptible for that handoff. Mogg got there, just went too high, and just when it looked like Clermont had squandered a couple of opportunities and back in their own 22 under pressure, Montpellier again, Sensi at the drive again, and one poor pass, and now Montpellier under their own 6, and they'll be very quiet in Montpellier. They won't be enjoying this at all.
They certainly won't. This is an easy enough conversion. A catastrophic try score last week at La Rochelle on the coast. On the coast of venue. He scores another on Lopez. Well, he could have done that with his eye shot, but as you say, a wonderful piece of individual skill, that one-handed pickup. Looks so easy on the television. Do this at pace, though, and try it in the back garden. And Mog was hunting him down. I was quite surprised at that, the big fend.
Yeah, so you've got to go low. You've done all the hard work to get back there.
Bleu sorti.
Body back on. He's been taped up. Stanley Hart, very straight line from him. Zirakashvili. You could see the fear in his eyes. There was daylight for the prop. Didn't like being in the wide open spaces.
They don't have too much time to think about things.
What a servant he's been to Clermont. Sorry, Nick. 12th season now. 196 top 14 appearance for the prop. Good to see him back. Broke his cheekbone and his arm last season. Struggled at scrum times for Clermont. Everything's relative. Without the big Georgian.
Good kick from Lopez onto Spieth. Didn't have a lot of time then to get any momentum.
I just wonder, we've seen it a couple of times, and saw it last week as well. Quite a lot of width to Montpellier. We possibly didn't see as trying to put a training ground backs move together after the driving ball there for Montpellier that led to the Nakatathi try. Are we seeing a little bit more width for Montpellier already this season than we saw last, or certainly ambition than we saw last season?
I think they'll look to develop their game, especially if you look at the wingers they've got as well. In the back three with Mog, Ball and Nadolo, you've got to get them the ball in space. I mean, Nadolo just got knocked into touch. They were just outside the 22 and they looked to move it. So they will have to be more adventurous. I think from the mall, actually, the ball was slowed down. The ref said they had to use it, and obviously they looked to bring their 130-kilogram winger in. They're making the right calls, just execution's not right. And we mentioned about the rustiness, and Nadolo hasn't been there long. And plays are that when you're under pressure. Players have lines they like to run. Again, the lineup's not functioning well. And
there's another winger they have at their disposal, not at the moment. His dog has eaten his credit card. We're talking about Timothy Ngutha, who's still back in Fiji. Had an extra week off after an operation on his hip, but hasn't been seen. He's due back on the 30th of July. Hasn't come back yet. So when he comes back, a couple of weeks of intense fitness training, I'd have thought.
Would he not be working on his fitness in Fiji, Johnny?
No doubt he is.
I've heard a few reasons why players are delayed getting back to pre-season, but it tends to be visa issues is quite a popular one. But they all lost a credit card. In fact, it's quite nice that he's let them know what's happened. I've known players who just have gone AWOL and just appear back, carrying a few extra pounds. But he's an incredible talent. So
top try scorer last season.
Yeah, incredible player. So he'll probably rock back and be able to slot back into the team and do what just about every other player can't do. So
turnover ball for Clermont again. Lovely inside ball from Nakatathi. Nakatathi, I should say. Put the teeth back into Fofana. There's Lopez again. Really flat. Nakatathi against Benjamin Farr. Dumoulin's gone in the side there. He's trying to turn that ball over, but Sanga says no, it's our ball. Because it's Tamani. Just seem to be a better understanding at the moment between the Clermont players and the Montpellier players. It's Shuli. I guess that comes from less changes in the off-season.
Exactly. But they're looking confident, aren't they, Clermont? They're getting ball on the front foot. I think their back line is just working together really well. If there's a half tackle, then there's an offload on the inside shoulder. Without really looking, they're anticipating that someone's going to be there. Really good play. That's the knock-on that lost them the ball in the end. But Fofana, Nakatake, ball in the right hand. Then the pass inside to Fofana again, looking for the handoff. And then the offload to Spedding. Said really working well together. Stanley's then in for the clear out, so they get quick ball again. Just said as a team and as a back line, there's no question that, and that's a poor penalty to give away. No way has he come anywhere near the back foot. He's Dumoulin, who's an experienced player, has just come flying in from the side and given another opportunity for Clermont.
And a rush of blood to the head, your first home game in the new club. And as you say, you just stay well out of there, because Lopez, in this kind of mood, is going to punish you, and that's exactly what he's done now. 16 points to 5.
It's a lovely ride. Lopez is getting at the moment. He's kicking well, got confidence from that, and then he's getting plenty of ball in his hand with options inside and outside. As a fly half, is exactly what you want.
But we've seen the variance in his game, haven't we? That exquisite, millimetre perfect and weighted kick for Fofana over the back line. He's kicking his goals, he's taking the ball up, standing nice and flat.
Yeah, this is what we know he can do. Stop. He's got the bearings in his game, he can take the ball to the line, he will have a go. So the chip was just exquisite. That's a shame they didn't finish that off. And another mistake from Montpellier, and listen to the crowd. When I was at Oyen, actually played Montpellier this time last year, and similar first half, very close, and the crowd quickly got on their back. They turned it around second half, but there is an expectancy, especially with all the money they're spending now, that there's even more pressure on the players to go out and perform.
And many of the Montpellier supporters haven't liked seeing so many foreign South Africans coming into their club side, a club side that has always prided itself on its youth development of players, of its academy, just like Clermont themselves.
I suppose when you get success, then those supporters will be a lot quieter, but if things start going wrong, they'll quickly turn. Obviously last year was probably the success, they won a trophy. But it's the top 14 that they want to be winning, and then I suppose that's the only way of keeping the supporters quiet is really being at the top of that league and pushing the Clermonts. And obviously 16-5 in your first home match of the season is not what the supporters or the players or the coaches were hoping for.
In the Champions Cup pool, Montpellier with Northampton, Leinster. Not easy. Clermont in the same pool as Exeter, Bordeaux-Bègles again this season, as they were last season. What a traumatic pool that was.
What a finish that last Sunday was on the Exeter and Clermont. I was
Sunday Morgan Parra wants to forget.
I suppose just in the heat of the battle, you can easily. No? You're looking at me in disagreement.
No, I just think you're being very kind.
No.
66 caps. You must know all you need to get is 1 point to get through the pool to hit a quarter final. All you have to do is kick the goal. Anyway, you've been there, I haven't. So
if it's on though, Johnny, isn't it? That is not his finest hour. And
oh, so you do agree with me?
Possibly was the wrong decision, wasn't it? In hindsight.
You've been in France too long. It's all jouer, jouer with you now.
It's only jouer if you score.
Oh,
score was the wrong decision.
Yep, there is something in that. There is the new laws. Ball at the back of the scrum. Nothing new from Ndolo, though. Smashed into Sanga. But managed to dislodge the ball, though, the humidity of scrum half. Can have a little bit of rust there as well. They've certainly hit their gears better than Montpellier. We watched Nahuolo knock it on again.
Poor from Nadolo, isn't he? He's up against a 50 kilogram soaking wet scrum half and Camille Lopez, who isn't the biggest hitting 10. And to be fair, they went low on him, both went low, and dislodged the ball. Clem will be disappointed to lose the ball as well.
He's literally all they're doing at the moment, isn't it, Montpellier? It's almost like kind of schoolboy rugby. He's get it to the big fella out wide, big quick fella. Every back's move is exactly what they're trying to do. He's get the ball in the man's hands. Perhaps trying to get their money's worth. Jesse Mock. He's just hoovering in around, isn't he? Nahuolo.
But that's what he's so good at as well. He drew in two defenders and had the ability to offload. He can run hard and straight when he has to, but he has the ability to see when he's pulled in two defenders and can then offload. Better for Montpellier. They kept the ball better, got the ball wide, but kept it as well. Obviously a bit unfortunate that Moore got tackled into touch, but there was an opportunity for Clermont. After Nadolo spilled the ball, Nakataki was a poor offload to Spedding. Plenty of mistakes, but at least both sides are trying to play a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. Unlike the non-classic bracketed game between Toulouse and Bordeaux Bergler through last night. Kvyashvili, another Georgian. Second spell at Montpellier to Toulon, and of course, Stade Francais. Lost a breathe yesterday, Stade Francais, despite being against 14 men for an entire half of rugby. Yanni Duplessis is the man to replace the Georgian international.
Montpellier will be desperate to try and get some points before half-time, just to narrow that gap a little bit. Equally, Clermont will be delighted if they could just go in with this 11-point lead.
That's a big lead. 11 points for Camille Lopez. A try for Nakatathi, his body. Sanga and Lopez. Onto the left boot. This one's gone high again. Different tactic. Testing Jesse Mock. Off Nakatathi and White. Many felt he was very unlucky to not be involved in the World Cup for Australia. Nick White.
Similar theme for Clermont. And anything on the right hand side, they look to hit up once and then use Lopez's left foot. A lot better for a left footer if he's going right to left. So obviously they're taking the pressure off the young scrum half Sanga, so he's not hard. I don't think we've seen him kick yet this half, so they're using Lopez a lot and then obviously putting those contestable bombs up on the 15. It's a good ploy from Clermont. As you can see, that they're well drilled without their exit plans. They go one phase, and if it's not really good ball, then they'll put the ball up with a good chase and try and compete in the air for it.
One of, if not the most consistent side in French rugby, if in European rugby, over the last decade, and only have one top 14 title and a Challenge Cup to show for it. Just four finals in the last 9 years, two European finals. Lost the semi-final of this top 14 competition last year. Won him off Dan Carter. Finished him off in extra time. Heartbreaking yet again. Feeling that is all too familiar from the men from the Auvergne. Lopez in this kind of move. Jesse Mock. Unusual way of diving down on the ball, normally on it, not just before it.
Great awareness from Lopez again. They defended it well from the scrum. Clermont then moved it to Nakataki and he's not going to kick it, and you don't want him to try and kick the ball. He ran back, but then afterwards it was Lopez, the awareness that there was, again, no scrum half behind. Nick White wasn't there, so there was plenty of space for Fofana to chase. Again, just varying the game a little bit, not just hoofing it down the park, it's seeing what's there, and also the communication with Fofana. Those two played plenty of time together, and you can see that there's a little bit of space, so just to vary it up a little bit.
We haven't seen some incredible rugby as we watch Paul Valencia's try from early on in this half. But actually, in terms of patterns, in terms of awareness, in terms of rhythm to their game, this is an impressive half of rugby from Clermont.
Mightily impressive. I think that the game's been quite open, which has suited them. I think Montpellier would be a lot stronger if they get set piece, which I think they've struggled if they get ball and are able to use their driving line out and use their power forwards. They can cause some damage, but when they're spilling ball and the ball's loose, that's when you get your Lopez, Fofana, Nakatake, who can create.
And they turn over now. Stay. Dimula. Benjamin Four was nowhere near, and it's again the handling errors from Montpellier. There's no excuse in terms of the conditions. Fulham says manhandling for Enzo Sanga. As John O'Gibbs looks on, he's manhandled a few scrum halves in his time.
See a little bit of inexperience from Sanga there. There's a chance to move it. He got caught with the ball. Luckily, there was a bit of advantage. But again, it's poor from Montpellier. Good turnover. Simple hands, got it wide. Got over the game line, kept the ball. It's better from Dumoulin. Got over the game line, and then it's just a bit of a one-up runner, but it's the mistakes you wouldn't expect Montpellier to make. It. Set piece, you can understand, because there's the partnerships that probably haven't, that aren't there at the moment, but just general play, then that's disappointing. That's poor from them, and again, it's giving Clermont a bit more hope, isn't it? A bit more confidence that actually this Montpellier side aren't firing at all.
I guess we were talking before this game kicked off, and you're saying, yeah, when you read their team sheet, it's just so many star names, so many quality players who play at the very highest level. I think, hey, how are we going to compete with them in our home patch? Well, okay, Clermont have got their own stars as well, but 11 point lead at half time. We're just 50 seconds away now from the half time break. Clermont will be very, very, very happy indeed.
Indeed, and a lot of these have come from errors from Montpellier. In fact, Clermont could have been further ahead with the opportunity they've created. They could be at least another score ahead, and actually Montpellier haven't created a huge amount apart from that try from the driving line out. They haven't offered a lot more, so I think if Clermont do go in with this 11 point lead, then yes, they'll be happy, but also slightly think, well, there's plenty more points out there for us.
Mohamed El Tradi, owner Montpellier, he's not enjoying watching his team that he has spent a great deal of money on being beaten at home. As that hooter goes, as Clermont put in a huge scrum, that is a massive statement to Montpellier. They're 11 points in the lead, huge scrum to finish the end of this first half. They are in the driving seat here at Montpellier, and the lead for Clermont is 16 points to 5.
By the looks of things, Morgan Parra's coming on, which is only going to enhance that partnership and the way that they have controlled the game. He's taken the pressure off the young scrum half, Enzo Sanga, 21-year-old, and who's had his chance and did fine, but I think that's a lot to do with Lopez took all the responsibilities of kicking, of the clearance, and got the ball in his hands a lot, which is obviously what you want. He's a key player for them, and you want him controlling the game.
You wonder whether he'll get the same amount of ball he did last time. Morgan Parra not shy on taking the ball himself, but as you say, takes that pressure off with the box kicks that Lopez has been doing himself. kicking for touch, etc., etc. But this is some lead. It's been some performance, possibly the performance of the top 14 seasons so far. Certainly the half from Clermont. Yes, mistakes certainly. Second round rustiness certainly. But in terms of stringing things together, nine out functioning well. Some nice offloading play. It's gone well as well. Clermont in control here.
You'd expect Montpellier to come out all guns blazing now. Really attacking this first 10 minutes.
Yeah, Spice in reverse gear. Mog. A lazy left boot of his. Spedding. Just clears, and I guess Clermont will say, well, we just do more of the same if we get the opportunities that come our way from Montpellier. Handling errors mainly in that first 40, wasn't it? We'll take them.
Yeah, and I think on that they probably look, well, we're happy to kick to touch because the Montpellier lineup's not functioning that well. So if Montpellier want to keep it on the park, then Clermont will, especially with Spedding, because he can get big distance, you can put it back into the Montpellier half and see how their lineup's functioning now, and hasn't been good in the first half, and see if they've made any improvements during half time.
And then it looks like the only change, isn't it, at 9-4, Clermont, Morgan Parrott, more direct. And Guerra without the scrum cap this half, and it's hot out there. A crossing Clermont are trying to claim, involving Franz Steyn. It's Dumoulin. Another little subplot within all this is, of course, Montpellier did the double over Clermont last season for the first time in their history. May just be at the back of the Clermont's minds.
Great kick from White. Two good phases from Montpellier, then again some lack of communication with the back line and made some errors, but Nick White's tied it up and put in a great kick and put a bit of pressure on Clermont.
And Clermont learned their lesson, didn't they, because Nick White, the last time he put that kick in, led to the Paul Vilimsa try, took the line out quickly, backed themselves, Spedding used his big right boot, and play comes back out to between the halfway and the 10 metre line.
Probably didn't see enough of that from White in the first half. He is a very good tactical scrum half, very good kick on him. It's probably the first good kick we've seen him put in.
And you've got a monster pack, especially a monster front five. Like Montpellier, then why not use it? That looked very flat to Dumoulin. Duplessis and Spice straight over the top. Catricalis tackled by Parra, but Parra's gone down. Looks like shoulder injury, possibly even just a stinger. Nereashvili. But Fofana has come up with the ball. Luga to Benson Stanley. No Rougeries on the bench today. Lamoureux, of course, in the ranks as well for Clermont. Now Jonathan Davies, of course, moved back to Wales, back to the Scarlets. Can want to keep the pace of this game up, I guess. It would have been spoken about before with this very heavy artillery pack that Montpellier have. Ndolo. Counter-rock from Clermont, this crowd pretty silent.
Eerie silence as the game's going on. Montpellier, they were obviously direct. They spoke about half-time about being direct and coming out, and they were good there. They crossed the game line four or five times, but again, I think it was Piers Spice who knocked the ball on, and from that, then Clermont were winning the kicking battle. They were finding space behind Montpellier and making their big wingers having to turn. Great tackle from Morgan Parra. Hopefully he hasn't injured himself.
He meant that as well, didn't he?
He did pick on the smallest Montpellier player to do it to, which is not a bad thing. But again, you're turning Ndolo, making him trying to run out, pick the ball up, and he doesn't want to be doing that.
It's just given Cami Lopez another opportunity, and he He's right in the groove this afternoon, Cammy Lopez. Power, bit of a stinger, sorted himself out, but if they keep giving Lopez and Clermont these opportunities, they'll just keep taking them, won't they? There is Sanga, Enzo Sanga.
Like I said, they're making it easy for Clermont. Clermont had to defend for 4 or 5 phases under pressure, but then all that pressure is just eased off because they've dropped the ball.
Mahino, he's not had his best day in terms of handling. Nick White fires it out to Aguera, who's got wonderful hands, great footballer, Capucci Aguera.
A great player, lucky enough to play with him at Gloucester, and great man to have on your side. Top defender, but a great carry as well. Actually quite a funny bloke off the pitch as well. Nice little giggle on him.
Pierce Smith, wonderful angle, wonderful pace, wonderful score. Two South African internationals combining Bismarck Duplessis to Pierre Spies. The pass looked flat. The pass looked forward, if we're honest. But the referee's given it.
Came from a turnover. Clermont lost the ball. Jesse Morg doing well, taking the ball to the line. I mean, it's a lovely angle from Spies, but I think if that had been in a way, if that had been Clermont given that ball, that could easily have been given a forward pass. But Pierre Spies, when he does catch the ball, when he's hitting the line at that kind of pace, you're not going to stop him because he has got so much speed for such a big guy. And he said, once he's through the line there, he's going to be hard to stop.
I just wonder, the referee was having a chat with the television match official as it was going on. This is definitely for the assistant referee, Nick, and this annoys some people. Look, he's 7 metres away from that.
To be fair, the referee and touch, they're both about 7 metres away, aren't they? And if they can't see, if they don't think that's forward, then look, you'd be disappointed if you're a Clermont supporter or player watching that, because that looked forward.
But it's a big call, it's a big time of the game. As Benoit Payot comes on, and it's a big decision because it's clawed them straight back into this game.
Straight away you've got the band playing, the crowd have lifted, because it was flat, there was nothing happening for Montpellier, and finally they've managed to create something, a bit of luck, and now they're back in the game.
Yeah, it's forward, certainly. But let's talk about the positives. It's been given out 7 points. Ketchikanis got the conversion. Wonderful angle for PSB. Kind of angle he used to run. Vidal, he might be saying, but getting towards the dusk of his career now. But that was an exquisite angle.
They managed to follow that up, they've taken the kick off and got a driving ball going, and are now putting the Clermont side under pressure. Another line out inside their 30. Will they look to use the same format and get the ball going, use that power game again?
Change the scrum half. Nick White off, Payou got.
Top player. If different to White, he's probably tactically not the same, but he's very busy. Will look to have a go, and very, very quick at sniping around the rucks.
He's far less structured than White, isn't he? Likes that ball in hand. Bardi, Vamahina, what? Has he put on his hands this afternoon? Well, he's great high standards, won't be happy with that. Spedding, you cannot. Well, you can, because they just have. If you're watching at home and you can't believe the PSP try wasn't given a forward pass, but that one is in the same bewilderment as we are.
Nothing to do with the fact was one was for the home side and one was for the away side, was it? There was a couple of flat ones going along the line.
Of course.
genuinely, I know there are stats to probably back this up, but he genuinely think referees, especially in the top 14, have it's like preference to the home team. Is that certainly felt amongst the players?
You have to go into an away match knowing that you have to be cleaner than clean, because there'll be penalties that if they're 50-50 they'll go against you. So especially scrum penalties, which are such a hard call anyway, but you'll find that, and obviously it works in your favour when you're at home and you get the crowd going. And I think it's not so much the referees, it's the assistant referees that are heavily influenced by the crowd behind them. They're the ones where the offside penalties that are called from the side, the forward passes that are or aren't called, I think those are the ones that are a lot more dubious.
Better scrum from Montpellier. Tricatis. This one out of Jesse Mott. And Dolo. Plante. And then brilliance from Fofana, or was it? Because he's handed the ball back to Pierre Spice. Adrien Plante has done very well all afternoon, hasn't he, to shepherd the huge Pigeon international.
His right shoulder might need a little bit of icing at the end of this game, but he's done well. He's gone low and chopped him on just every time he's got the ball.
Tomari tackling on Dumoulin. Lopez on his opposite number, trying to whip that ball away. Payo has to stay honest against him as a defender. Snipes around those, rucks on those more. There's Gianni Duplessis tackling. Benjamin Forlan and Guerra through first tackle, and in the end Raphael Schoen takes the back row.
Better from Montpellier. They definitely don't look as structured as Clermont do when they've got the ball, but when they can offload they look dangerous. Kibusin Kerry, he's powerful guy, typical Fijian, can offload and looks for the one-hand carries. They're better for Montpellier, so the crowd are lifted, they're getting some ball, they're going through the phases. Still think the open game will favour Clermont though.
Yeah, at times, I mean, they do have A and B, don't they, to their games in terms of the way to play. They're wonderful to watch at times. Brilliant counter-attacking team with the likes of Strettel, Benner and Spedding, Plante and Akatafi. Some wonderful players out there. And then they can also play in a big physical game where they grind teams into submission with the power plays.
You have to in France, especially when the weather turns and the pitches we see now, they do cut up, they get boggy, and you're going away from home to tough places. Brive, especially places like that, where it's hard to get the wins, and you have to grind them out. You have to have a pack that's going to compete, because if you don't, then you'll lose a lot more games than you'll win. So you've got to have the ability to grind out and win those tight matches, as well as the ability to create and score from nothing, which they've got an abundance in their back line.
They've only won one of the last four away games. That was against Pau, around 23 last season, Clermont. Benjamin Fort. It's catching. But they do have this tough start to the season. Clermont, Stade Francais away, then Racing at home, Bordeaux at home, Toulon away. Difficult fixtures for them.
Benjamin Fall not having his best game so far.
Some of that cavalry that we were talking about before this game kicked off. Victoria has come on the young second row. I mean, that man needs no introduction, does he? Emilien Rougerie, effectively the mayor of Clermont-Ferrand. And the man who was on earlier, Tassili Yato. Just bring a bit of calmness to proceed as Aurélien Rougerie. He has been there and done it. He's got the t-shirt, the tea towel, the special commemorative tray, the lot.
Do you think he's waited for Nadolo to tire slightly to then make his appearance?
He's in the last year. He has been a wonderful servant. How many one club men can you name nowadays? There's not too many winners' medals to show for it. Nadolo tackled by Ruggeri, his first act.
Two-man tackle on Nadolo, he's still got the ball away.
Ineshvili. Turia. Try score last week, the replacement second row. Again, pass looked forward, again looked like a bit of a knock-on.
Lovely click on from Steyn, but he had created the overlap. Clermont tried to shoot out the line to block the pass. Steyn did really well to flick it on, but couldn't get that extra ball away.
Player down for Montpellier. Right in the middle of play as well. Thought the referee would have stopped play for a moment. Can't recognise the boots at this juncture. Oh, it's Dumoulin, isn't it? Oh, he was smashed by Bardi. There's a Stanley as well with a tackle. Whammo.
Very Lomu-esque, isn't he? The way that big left hand carry and ability to fend and then offload. It always attracts two or three defenders. Great that he's got so much ball today for us to see him, his ability to do that.
We'll give him the ball or use him as a decoy man. We're having a look at this so that TMO, I'm not entirely sure why. Are you, Nick?
I check live. It's okay.
He's checked and he's okay.
What was he checking?
Maybe that. Just how good a tackle it was, possibly.
It could be the only thing.
Just really enjoyed a good bit of two-man tackling.
Again, there was lots of whistles, wasn't there, the first replay. We are playing on with the original penalty, and that is a hell of a nudge.
Lovely kick from Spedding. The difference it makes if you actually go for the extra distance. Spedding's got a big kick, yes, but working the angle rather than just taking your 15 or 20 metres and being 30 metres out. The difference it makes from being 7 metres out now is such a different mindset for both sides. Clermont are now going, this is a chance to score. Montpellier going, God, this is going to be hard to stop this.
Absolutely committed to the kick, isn't it?
I think it's great when you see players really going for it. Not just being happy with chucking it into Rosette and going, well, we've made 15 metres, that's it, fine. It's positive. Yes, Johnny, that was what I did, yes. Tried to do. And Luger. The forward's good.
Just went off without the ball. Bismarck Duplessis was there. Ujago, that's Duplessis again, the hooker. And Montpellier burst out of defence. Robin Taliwachu is on. There he is, the white scrum cap. Best name in French rugby. Not a bad player either. Catricalis. Saw Valimsa outside. It wasn't too keen on giving it to the big second row. Here's Ruggeri.
Clermont did well to come up hard on the outside so Catricalis had no option to pass. Possibly has to look to stand a bit deeper and look to give the ball early to his centres rather than taking it too flat.
Power up. Like clearly quite trying to turn Nadolo, aren't they? Trying to play their rugby in Montpellier territory. There's 7-point lead still.
Clermont really disappointed. We took a great kick from Spedding, put him in such a top position, won the line out, and then something happened at the back of the line and dropped it. look where they ended up. It's all about building pressure on a side. That was the first time in the 22. Just dropped the ball. The ball was going, the ball was going forward.
Uluga. Man who dropped it, no Benjamin Kayser at the moment. Good bicep injury. New props for Clermont. Tajot and Clermont Rick. Spenning bounces off his shoulder. Katrakalis.
Good kick from Katrakalis. So put Spenning in a lot of pressure. Had to try and get up for it.
Stanley's raced up to meet Mogg. Tamani's a tackle, he's fine there.
Paul was a little bit lucky there because not for a second was he looking at the ball.
But by your rationale, he's at home, so it's fine.
It's absolutely fine. A very good peripheral vision, clearly.
McLean would love to emulate what they did last season. They started at such a pace, really put a statement down, didn't they? Haven't beaten in the first five games. Four of those were victories, and good victories as well. They were scoring a hatful of tries. A little mid-season dip is quite often the way with French teams.
Surprising because they were missing a lot of their World Cup players at the start of the season, but we had them early on and they were in great form.
Katrakalis, where's he going here? Rougerie's not small. Dealt with that very easily. And they get that ball away, Spedding and Rougerie. There's Fofana. Just delaying play to allow the forwards to come back. Chile demands some support now.
Montpellier have tried this a few times to hold the attacker up to get the turnover. Clermont need to clear their lines, they're under a bit of pressure.
Would Spedding see something, is he? Door slammed very quickly. Sujago's trying to counter on their stay, is furiously telling the referee what the decision should be.
Well, but it's slightly lucky not to get done for diving over the top.
And Lopez in the end. This is beginning to get a little bit tasty, isn't it now? Montpellier realise significance of the first game at home. They're not everybody's favourites in the top 14. Plenty of musings in the Montpellier fans forum about the signings and the changing of the culture. News at home and they will soon get on their backs.
They're putting Clermont under pressure now. Even then it took Clermont three phases just to clear their lines.
Just beginning to turn that screw up. Tell you what, you. Putting it down, Clermont.
Clermont under pressure now. Tried to stop them all before he got going. But illegally took the guy in the air. What would you do here, Johnny?
3 points. You?
I think that the kick to the corner is what Clermont don't want. They would probably be happy to take a 4-point lead and go back into the Montpellier half. So for me, I think this is a good call. Whether it's the right decision, we'll see. But I like it because it's what Clermont don't want. And it's a good kick right in the corner.
And they feel they've got a bit between their teeth and they feel that Clermont under pressure. See all of that. Ben Bottinger comes on a fly half. Important as they just go into the final quarter of this game. Tell you, watch you again.
the man who takes the line, but Clemmer are dealing with it well. Shuley will have to get back ground, but they are moving forward very, very slowly. Montpellier, they feel they're over the line now. Steyn is celebrating. There's not going to be a clear angle of that one.
D'accord, c'est clair et net ou tu veux toujours vérifier? On vérifie. Ouais. Vidéo.
I'm going to the TMO.
Adrien, est-ce que tu m'entends?
Important,
juste,
je voudrais
vérifier par rapport au mall. Y a-t-il laissé oui ou non? On a un doute, peut-être que le joueur perd le contrôle du ballon avant d'aplatir. Merci.
Try yes or no.
You'd have thought they got there unless someone dropped it. I think they have dropped it. That's, although it possibly hasn't gone. You can't give that, can you?
I would have gone for 3 points.
They did the hard work. They got over the line. I mean, it looks to be a penalty against Clermont the way they've come round in the side anyway. But I think Maul's in front in the top 14 tend to be a bit more of a free for all than it would be in other places. But he's over the line, but the ball's not with him.
It's Bismarck Duplessis, isn't it? Yep. Quite often is in this role near the try line, but the ball's between his legs. It's certainly not been touched down.
There's no way they can give it as a try.
They are at home.
Whether I think the best case for Montpellier would be a scrum for their putting if the ball's gone backwards, but if you've dropped the ball, it's that looks the best angle, doesn't it?
Did he try and feed it back through his legs and therefore possibly not even to his own knowledge that no, that's dropped. Dropped before he's pushed it between his legs. He knows it as well.
The crowd is still cheering. I'm not sure what for, d'accord. But
just a bit of honesty. Crowd think it's a try. They should try opening both eyes because that in anybody's language is knocked on with this. See what the decision.
Le joueur perd en avant.
Never in doubt was the right decision going to come from that. And 3 points was the right option, Johnny, was it?
15-19. Still got 20 minutes left on the clock. Just saying.
That'll be debated on Monday or Tuesday in their video debrief, where half the room will say we should have gone for three and the other half will say the proof will be what happens to the rest of the game, I guess.
Yeah, a big scrum here. Both teams need to lock out here. Clermont, it's like they're doing that. That's a great scrum. Great defensive scrum, it really is. Then Bits and Stanley, let's just get more of an angle for the kicker. Now it's Parrott, scrum half. The best of passes to Lopez. He gets it off. Mandolo. There's no one near. Jesse Mogg wasn't interested. And it's a good exit from Clermont and Montpellier. Could be 15-19 up.
Such a great exit from Clermont. Under pressure. 5 metre scrum under pressure to lock that out. Then to move the ball to Stanley to carry. To create the angle for Lopez to kick. It looks simple, but it's so effective there. Away from home to do that. That's what wins you matches in this league.
So much has been written about Clermont not being able to finish leagues off or finals off. It's just a sign there that's under immense pressure for Montpellier. They've certainly had the rub of this game for the last 5-10 minutes to be that close to the line,
to exit like that, to have the composure, to have to back yourselves and your skills as a team, as individuals, that is superb from Montpellier, from Clermont, I should say, as good as anything we've seen from them all day.
Exactly, and that's what we talked about, the squad not being changed a huge amount, the understanding of what they're going to do. When they've got a scrum 5 metres from their line on the right hand side, they're going to go 8 to 12, who carries, get over the gain line, then back to Lopez, who's got more of an angle to kick. So it's that understanding of the team, that the players have been there for a number of years that know what they're going to do then. He said that's what the good sides can do. Yes, they can create. Yes, Lopez can do little chips over the top, but he's also making the right calls and executing it perfectly.
There's nothing new in what they did, just mentally have the strength to go for that. Okay, people would say it's only round two and it's an away game, but it feels like it's bigger than a round two game, doesn't it? This feels like these two will be there or thereabouts come the end of the season, and this is about possibly a look back to last season when Montpellier did a double over Clermont's Vincent Dubati and Raphaël Schaum and Sébastien Valmahina look on. All smiles and head dug out. Possibly a look back to Montpellier doing a double over Clermont last season, but to know that they've beaten Montpellier on Montpellier's home patch could prove very useful come the final shake-up with this top 14.
Gives you a huge amount of confidence when you can beat a top side away from home. You don't get a lot of wins in France, so to do that. Rougerie will be delighted that Odolo put a nice little grubber kick through.
I say keep it in hand.
It's surprising the amount of solid scrums we've had today. A lot of scrum ball. Don't normally get this amount. It's great to see, isn't it, that we're not seeing a lot of resets, we're not seeing a lot of scrum penalties, that we've seen a lot of ball coming out.
Turia. Big high hopes for this new young crop that have come through the Clermont Academy. Paul Jedrzejczyk, of course, in the second row, but already a French international. Victoria in the French development training squad, as is his teammate Concordia, the flanker who's gone off. Former academy captain, young second row, under pressure at the line out, as is Ben Bottiger, is pressure in a contact situation. Still 7 points the difference, 15 minutes left in this game. Final game of round two. Spinning. Just had the ball ripped away from him from Brad Steck. Tell you what, Chip.
Steyn did so well because it wasn't a great chase, but first up tackle by Mogg was good, and then the follow up by Steyn.
Good to Martin. Gets an introduction to the game, isn't he? Former teammate of yours. From IO.
Yeah, good, a really good athlete, Vincent Martin. He came from Toulon, had a year with us. He's now in Montpellier, but the low chop from Jesse Morgan, staying straight on the ball. Great turnover. Great hit by Stanley on Quera as well. Real pocket rocket, isn't he, Stanley? Not the biggest, but huge amount of power.
More Blues man, of course. Three caps for New Zealand, only the summer of 2010, yes, 6 years ago now. And he's 24 years of age. Two of those caps against Wales. 2010.
Really good footballer. Him, Fofana, a really good partnership. And we had Jonathan Davies there last year as well. A real strength there.
Rougerie. Now adding to that, Lamarat.
Lamarat's a good player, yeah. From Cass.
Flexion.
Very strong carrier. Did really well with Cass last year.
Well, Stanley was always going to be a reasonable player, wasn't he? Decent stock. Nephew of Joe, of course. 27 caps in the midfield for New Zealand.
Good 30 metre gain for Clemon. Again, good solid scrum. Ball wide, and they've used another kicker for Fana this time, put it through. That's your poor return from Mogg.
Away to Paris next weekend. Clermont, whom you can see on Sky Sports lunchtime. Saturday. Stade Francais. Lost yesterday, and they did a brief. A lovely offload from Stanley, and it's Yato. Oh, what a step! What a quality try that is. Benson Stanley from nowhere gives the offload, and then this man Yato, who we've seen several times running tries at 30 odd metres. What a step, what a finish, and that may well be the ball game.
Five man line out from Clemmer, they cut it, they've used a decoy run up. Stanley's hit a great line, but managed to get his hands free. Montpellier have looked to try and cut the ball off, but they've left a weak inside shoulder, so Stanley's got his hands free. Yato's hit a perfect line and has hit the ball at pace, and that's a great step for a big guy to step off his left foot at that speed as well. That's a great try, and came from how Clermont made 30 metres on their scrum play. They got the ball in the Montpellier half. Good ball off the top of the line out, and a clinical move.
And showing real quality, real resistance. Some 5 minutes ago, captain their line. We were looking at a Bismarck Duplessis possible score. Montpellier were very much on the up. He rode that storm, of course. In a game, your opposition are going to have purple patches. Clermont ridden that. Possibly Montpellier should have gone for the 3 points, but they've ridden that storm and come back and scored a 7-pointer of their own.
That's the thing. The good side is just stay in games. Like I said, there'll be periods where you're under pressure, but it's just sticking with it. And if the teams really have to make the other teams work hard to get tries, to get points, and if they do, well done. But when you get your opportunity, especially away from home, you might not get that much. When you get a chance to create something, go and do it and take that. And they've done that this half especially.
Don't often lose leads either, Clermont. The 14-point lead. Vlimsa is now getting smashed in the tackles as well. Aluga, in the absence of Cage, has been putting himself around here at the Al-Chad Stadium. Here's Jesse Moore. What can he do with Bismarck Duplessis? There's Benson Stanley, the try-assist man.
You can hear someone shouting discipline from the sideline, but the players aren't listening. And the defence looked so strong. Montpellier weren't going anywhere. There's some big hits coming in. One high tackle has let them off the hook. Montpellier are going to have to chase in this last 10 minutes.
Yeah, now they have to go to the corner, don't they? And it's been hugely physical. What an offload. Pierce Spies hanging on your back, and you still got that kind of offload away. It just so happens that you and I were talking about what a great player Benson Stanley was a minute or two before, and the power he possessed, but he showed not just power, but great skill there in that offload to Yato. And now Montpellier want to respond. They've knocked it on again. But after, who is it? Tamani is coming around the side. Votica is back into that corner.
There's a feeling of an inevitability about this try coming from. If they keep hold of the ball, then you'd be surprised if they don't get over the line. And in fact, it wouldn't be a bad thing if they did concede quickly. What Clermont don't want is penalty and a yellow card, and then the try.
Brilliant shot. He's the man, put it on in. Duplessis.
No,
Bismarck. And Dolo. France staying out of even more weight to it. Bismarck, Duplessis, as you say. Inevitability about that one from Montpellier, from the man who often scores those driving ball tries and lineouts. Bismarck, Duplessis, one of Jake White's favourite sons. And they claw five back.
Clermont tried to compete because they knew once that ball was set it would be hard to stop, so tried to compete to get the ball, didn't do that, which makes it even harder then when you've got to try and stop the ball. And Montpellier added their backs toward to the to add some weight behind it, and Adolo joined it, and Ben Botticum even joined it. Not sure what fly half's doing in a mall, but you said there's back in the game, 7-point game.
Botica. Conversion is successful. All 12 points last week for Ben Botica. It's too early this afternoon. He's gone for Dimitri Katsoukalis. It's a good response from Montpellier.
Discipline is going to be huge for Clermont now, because they don't want to give field position away. The way the Montpellier driving line-out is going, they're going to be hard to stop or hard to not to concede penalties against.
Triple tackle on Adolo. Spice. Clermont Rick pops out there. Great turnover from Clermont. What a place to do it. And there's numbers here for Fana. He's chipped that one through. Turning Adolo, I can understand that. With what's just happened in the last few minutes with where the field position they were in.
You would think with 6 minutes to go, you get the ball in the 22, it's about keeping ball and keeping possession. Hopefully getting a penalty, and that puts you two scores ahead. The kick wasn't on, and
you don't want to
Rougerie play. Wasn't really on the same page as Fofana either.
Now France Steyn's getting fractious about the 22 dropout. This will be hoisted. Spitz. Good chase of his own kick from Lopez. Bardi is eventually rocked out of the way. Botica. Biagari, Johan Biagari, replaced with hookers on. Luga putting himself around, giving a couple of penalties away with big hits of the young hookers on. Peyouk to Spice. Crowd getting themselves involved. Bismarck Duplessis. Had to be careful. That touchline looming. Rougerie shepherding him well. Votremet on the field now. Replacement prop. Wilimsek against Schuling. That's halfway. Pale. This is what he can do. Floats it inside. Get another one of those passes we like to have a look at. But to Guerra, who plays off, flips it up to Yannick Duplessis. Djaga.
They're getting gain line, they're getting their arms free, they're getting offloads, they're getting behind the Clermont defence, Montpellier.
The Clermont time, there's a man down, Telly Watchu takes it off. Said, didn't we, Payo. The time defence is so alert around the breakdown, saw a half gap as France Steyn now takes up. There's a scrum half again, but there's not much there for Botticoat to play with, so he puts it in the air. Probably around, goes out of touch. Loud blast on the referee's whistle.
Good attack from Montpellier. Kept the ball offloaded. They're going to tire Clermont defence, but they did well because they kept it and they got behind it. Benoit Pelé was sniping around as we mentioned and got the arm three. We saw Steyn carrying a few times. And now they've got the penalty.
It's a break from Payok.
That's level, isn't it? Or is that 3 metres forward?
I'll go with your second option. Was there a third option of a metre and a half? Because that would be my preference.
That is good rugby. That's what we want to see, Johnny, isn't it?
It's been, as you said, it's been a tremendous second half, isn't it? Real seesaw and affair.
Captain.
We thought Captain. It might be the way. We said this, didn't we? The beginning before this game, just a feel of a big heavyweight contest. The two big French giants going at it, and that's exactly what it's ended up being. They're now going for the posts.
What would your call be here, Johnny? 3 points, which gets them within, that gets them the losing bonus point, doesn't it? But also the chance to come back and win the game if they score a try. After they've just had three driving lineouts that have given them penalties and a try.
The decision was for the penalty for 3 points. And they have got those 3 points through Potica. It's not missed so far in a Montpellier shirt, but Potica.
I wonder if that was a call from upstairs to take the three. For me, I'd go to the corner. Your driving line ball is going so well. As long as you keep the ball, you're looking like you're going to score. The conversion gets you to a draw. Now you're in your own 22 and you've got to go 80 metres in just over 2 minutes.
The only time the driving ball didn't go well was the other time they had a penalty and went to the corner. They're going to come away from this game with something. And for large chunks, especially in that first half, they have been second best. Oh, that's what's great about the game of rugby though, isn't it?
Look, 1 point could be better, but we'll see. I know what the crowd would probably like to see.
Spelling is smash mark. Spelling says, oh, the whistle hasn't gone. Long shot. Was in touch. So therefore the line-out will be in line with where Spelling kicked the ball. Or was it just Linesman? So it's quite difficult to see that one. He's seen that one though, the assistant referee.
There's not much in that. Yeah, Moggs done really well. And that's a big call because that's gone from, it could be a line out to Clermont just outside the 22. Now Montpellier have got it on the halfway line.
Trying to get their superstar involved, the man. It's a great deal of money, but he's knocked it on again. Almost infatuation to get that offload away, just needed to keep hold of the ball. Frank Hazemat, he realises what a statement this could be. Men on a mission, the men from Montpellier. They've not made many friends in. Jake White and his decisions in around French rugby, even Montpellier themselves, but they can't enforce this afternoon for their first home game of the season, and they're watching their team lose to, in terms of the giants of French rugby, lose to one of their nearest and dearest. And the free kick from a scrum, and there we go, they will play this out. Clermont, there it is, Morgan Parris says, there we go. And Clermont, you can see what it means to the players. That is a superb victory for Clermont, one of the favourites to lift this title. That is the biggest statement of this top 14 season so far. Clermont win it, 26 points to 22.